you know what items in your aircraft must be operable to be legal for that flight? Well, first of all, if you have an MEL, which is a minimum equipment list, then the rules are a little bit different. An MEL is a list approved by the FAA for that specific aircraft. It'll tell you exactly what items are on that aircraft and what have to work and what don't have to work to be legal. And if one of the items on that list is not required to be working, then you would have to go get the mechanic, and the mechanic has to come inspect it, and then they defer it in the log books. And then the next time the aircraft goes in for maintenance, then they'll address it. But if you have an MEL, you must get the mechanic to defer that item for you. Now, if you don't have an MEL, then we use the list in the FAR-AIM under Part 91205. And it's a very specific list that says exactly what must be working on board your aircraft. Now, if you have something that's inoperative that's not on that list, then the pilot themselves may placard it inoperative and then go fly the aircraft. And then the next time it goes in for maintenance, the mechanic will tend to it. But if you have an MEL, the mechanic has to defer it and placard it inoperative. If you don't have an MEL, the pilot may defer it, the pilot may mark it inoperative. Now let's look at the list for the daytime required items and plus the nighttime required items. And your memory aid for the daytime items is A, tomato flames. And what that stands for is your anti-collision light. Your anti-collision light is your red beacon light, or it could be a combination of a red beacon light slash white strobe light. There are two T's, and that stands for your tachometer gauge has to be working, and the other T is for a temperature gauge if liquid cooled. So if you had a radiator, then you would have to have a special type gauge for that. So temperature gauge if liquid cooled. There are two O's, and that stands for oil pressure and oil temperature. And this list also pertains to a complex aircraft, one where the landing gear goes up and down and where you can control the pitch of the propeller. So on that list also, we have manifold pressure gauge, and then the other M is for our most primitive form of navigation, which is our magnetic compass. We have two A's, and that stands for your altimeter. And also your airspeed indicator. The F stands for your fuel gauges must work. And the L is for your landing gear position lights. So if you had a retractable gear airplane, the landing gear position lights, which let you know if the gear is up or down, have to be working. So landing gear position lights. Okay, the E is for ELT, and the S is for seat belts. Now remember, there are a couple instances when the ELT may be removed for maintenance for a certain period of 90 days, or if you're providing flight instruction and do not go beyond 50 nautical miles, and then there's a couple other examples as well where the ELT doesn't have to be working. For night, it's all of your day items plus these for night, and it really has to do with your lighting. It has to do with your fuses, if your aircraft has fuses. Many of the newer aircraft just have circuit breakers. The L is landing light, but only if for hire. So if the aircraft were for private use or also flight instruction, the landing light does not have to work. But if it's any other type of flight that's generating income, the landing light has to work. The A is your anti-collision light. The P is your position lights. And your position lights are your red and green on the wings, and then your white tail light. And then S is your source of electric. So either your generator or alternator has to be working. Now, also with the fuses, if you do have fuses in your aircraft, the number of fuses that are required is one of each type or three, or a set of three if you have multiple. So let's say in your aircraft you had fuses like this. So in this instance, I would have to carry a 1, I would have to have 3 5s, a 7, and a 10, because I have one of each type or 3 if I have multiples of those. So that's the type of fuses you have. Now, you need to definitely commit these to memory, or at least know where to find them in the formula, which is part 91205, because your examiner on your check ride will expect you to know and understand these, and what to do if something other than one of these is inoperative in the aircraft. So do go back and study these really well. Your examiner will ask you them.